Hi, welcome to Stars TV here with Captain AJ McLean after the Fife game. AJ, we won't go into it too much, but obviously it's been a week of turmoil, well, you know, upheaval in the Stars camp, but everything seems to be sorted now and the team's responded really well to the change.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough to see a good guy like Dan go, but that's the nature of the business. You never want to see that, but I think with change it comes a great responsibility, and I think the guys this weekend, we played well in Cardiff for 50 minutes. The last 10, we didn't execute as well as we wanted. A couple penalties, ends up 6-2 instead of 3-2, or who knows what happens if we keep executing. Tonight, I thought for 60 minutes, we played the way we wanted to. We executed our game, and it showed on the score.
Yeah. You seem to be doing well against Fife this season, personally. I mean, that's another game where you've got goals against them. Does it feel better to get goals against a team like Fife because they're a big rival?
Well, it feels good to score a goal anytime.
Yeah.
But if you can help chip in big rivalry games, you can hear the fans roaring, and that's awesome. But whether it's Fife or Edinburgh or Nottingham or any of those teams, when you score, it feels great regardless.
Yeah. I'm sure a few fans will be wondering. You seem to have a bit of a discussion out there with Matt Siddle tonight. Was there a lot of back and forth between the two of you tonight? Was there anything going on?
No.
Just on the ice? Yeah,
no, there's nothing. Nothing to it.
Nothing to read into it?
No.
Yeah. All right, after a performance like that, where the team responded well to a new coach, went out and beat 5-7-1, and by all accounts had a close game in Cardiff, does it breed a lot of confidence that we can go ahead and start to really beat big teams now and move up the table into a playoff place?
Yeah, when we played in Cardiff, we could see that what we were trying to do, things were there, but it was our first game trying to execute these nice simple plays that were here, and sometimes we did, sometimes we didn't, and it ended up reflecting in the last 10 minutes when we didn't execute, pucks went in our net and we took penalties. Tonight we executed a lot better, and it went the other way where we were putting pucks in the net. So I think the guys have a positive outlook. They can see when we do it right, and when we want to do things our way, things work out, and if we don't, it ends up in our net.
Yeah. Just finally, we're going away to Belfast on Saturday and then Brayhead at home. These are two teams that we've proven this season we can give a game to. How are you feeling about going into those two games this weekend?
Good. We usually play them both really well, so we're looking forward to it. We have another 3 days of practice to get ready, and we'll do our homework, get to work, and we'll be ready for Friday, and then we'll take Saturday when it comes.
Yeah. All right, AJ, thanks for your time today. Cheers.
Thank you.
Hi, welcome to Stars TV here with new Stars coach Brent Hughes. Brent, there are going to be some people that are going to say that's a meaningless game, but there are about 1,500 people out there who it's not meaningless to tonight, aren't there?
And there's about another 18 guys in the dressing room.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
You know, that was one thing we said before the game was, we're going out there and we're going to compete for each and every guy in this dressing room. We're not going to let the guy beside you down tonight. We're going to come over here and we're going to make a statement. I said, first half of the season's over, second half of the season's ours.
Yeah. Even though Fife were resting guys, we played a lot better tonight. There seemed to be far more speed through the neutral zone, far more, you know, passes finding sticks. Did you find that as well tonight?
Absolutely. And, you know, it's the old saying, hard work pays off. And, you know, one of the biggest things tonight, you know, it wasn't the skating, it wasn't the passing, it was the communication out there on the ice. That's the biggest part, you know, in playing a hockey game is knowing where each other are. And, you know, the guys put together a full 60 minutes tonight. You know, Fife can come back and say what they want to say. They let guys sit out, whatever. You know, we're going to come out here every single game. Like I said, I don't care who we're playing. It doesn't matter if we're on the home or if we're on the road. We're coming out here with the same mentality. We're going to go out there and compete 60 minutes.
Yeah. Just to briefly talk about last night in Cardiff, by all accounts, that wasn't, you know, 4-0. A four-goal margin wasn't a fair reflection on how the teams played that night.
No, I think we competed hard for 50 minutes, and then you know, we kind of lost focus, taking some penalties, letting the referees get into our head, and that's one thing that's really come back to haunt us throughout this whole season so far. So, you know, we competed hard for 50 minutes. Yeah, they got a lot of shots, but there were a lot of outside shots.
Yeah.
You know, we kept them to the outside a lot, which was one thing that we wanted to do. You know, we were forcing them to dump a lot of pucks, which isn't their game. You know, they want to pass through the middle and attack with speed. So we did a lot of good things, you know, especially for our first game as a group. I thought, it was good, and you know, there's little things that we can tweak, but I mean, that's what we got Wednesday, Thursday, Friday for, and then it's back to work again.
Yeah. If we could just have a quick word about the fans tonight and the atmosphere in the building and how much that helped the team.
It's amazing, but you know, our fans get behind us when we give them something to cheer about.
Yeah.
You know, and that's something that we need to do every single time we're at home. And you know, we got our road fans as well. You know, we play well, they'll respond, and they'll become even louder, and that just helps us continue to go harder and harder and harder. So, like I said, you know, the fans are always going to be there for us. We got to start showing up for them game in and game out.
I asked AJ, but if I could just get your take on how you're feeling about Belfast and Brayhead this weekend.
Well, those are two teams that we've played strong. Obviously, we've played two strong games at home against Belfast.
Yeah.
We're looking to change that on the road. We're going to, you know, go over some game film this week, and then you know, try to reiterate some of that stuff that we've seen in the tapes on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and just get ourselves prepared. And then coming home on Sunday, you know, it's just it's another home game, another game that we got to come out here and compete 60 minutes. And it's like I've said, I'm going to keep saying this over and over again, is I don't care who we're playing, where we're playing, we're coming out and we're competing for 60, and we're not going to get outworked.
Yeah. Well, great start at home for your coaching, Brent. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much. Cheers. Thanks.
Thank you, Brent.